What's up, guys? If you missed the last video, my name's Nick. I'm a 27-year-old engineer in Southern California. And October 1st, I'm moving into this van and bringing all this stuff with me. So the van is 2008 Ford E350 extended. So she's a big boy, big girl, and 6-inch lift kit and 4-wheel drive. And she's on 35s. As for the roof, I got a U-joint roof rack and I have floor paneling in the front half. Then I also have a Yakima box for extra storage and it's mounted on some two-lay bars. So I'll take you up there in a second, we can check it out. As for the gear, I got a bunch of climbing gear, 3 surfboards, 10-0 Surf Crime nose rider, 6.5 Bonzer Rush Short, 5.8 Bonzer. Kind of in love with the Bonzers right now. I think they're the best boards, the best feeling bottom turns. Also have a Progression 140 surf foil, some Mizuno golf clubs, and finally but not least, a Salsa Horse Thief, 2019 full suspension, 140 travel front in the front, and then 120 in the rear. So that's like the majority of gear, and the majority of the hobbies I'll be doing while traveling full time in the van and working full time at the same time, which is why I'm dressed like this, because I just got off of work. But you guys gave me so much love and support in the last video. Wanted to make sure to pump this one out for you guys. So with that, I think I'll take you guys up on top of the roof. And then after that, we'll go to the back and then to the side. I'll take you guys inside to end it. I'm also pretty sick right now, which is why my voice sounds like this. But climbing up the ladder. So as you can see, pretty dirty right now, but got this nice floor paneling here, and then left a pretty big gap under the box. That's where that 10-0 longboard is gonna go. And then also have some tie down straps positioned around this front half. In the back, you can see a front fork mount. That's where the mountain bike is gonna be mounted. And it's pretty stable. Also, you can see I have the vent fan in the roof right over there. It's just on top of the bed on the inside. We go around to the side and the back. This actually was initially a sliding bike tray because I was gonna keep the bike inside. But then at the time I just had a twin bed. I decided I don't wanna sleep next to a mountain bike every single night. So I converted it to a full and then converted this bike tray into more of just a storage tray. So right now I have camp stove, a bunch of surf gear, and then some climbing gear. And then you can see all the storage space underneath the bed. Then on this half is where I put the 2 Bonzers and then also the surf foil setup. And then of course, gotta have a rinse kit. Golf clubs also fit in that space. And then you can see it just slides in nice and easy. Boom. That easy. The sliders are definitely the hardest thing to put on during this build. I think I have 4 of them positioned around the van, and by far the most difficult thing to get both sides perfectly level so things actually slide in. But totally worth it once you get them in. And then also, of course, I have a safe jack. So because my van's so lifted, you have to get like a special jack. So I have that hydraulic jack in case I need to change a tire. Let's move on to the side and go to the interior. So coming to the interior, this is kind of the layout whenever you enter the van. So you can see I have some storage space over here. Pretty good size drawer. And then if you look below this, you can see I left quite a bit of space here. And that's so I can have up to 8-0 longboard or fun board, whatever you want to call it, inside the van. And then just some little hangers here for towels and jackets. 0-degree sleeping bag just in case it gets freezing. And the entire van is insulated with wool. So I haven't had to use that yet. And I also have a diesel heater. You can see it right there underneath the Yeti. It's where the fan is for it. And then a diesel tank in here. And I've used that in Mammoth in 0-degree weather. And it's amazing. Keeps me super warm. It's very efficient. I think the reviews I read, it's a lot more efficient. And then propane, and then you also don't get the dampness that you can get with propane. So back to the van tour. Also a little drawer right here for extra storage. Paper towels everywhere. Of course I got the passenger seat able to rotate. Take a seat here. You can see my Yeti is on a slider. So if I untie this, it'll come out nicely, but tucked away whenever I'm not using it. Also water and then battery AC to DC, so you can charge all my devices really easily. And then kind of see the rest of the van there. So storage on the left and on the right, and then the battery that runs the fan and the heater is right there. I'm just using this one for simple quick charging, and something I can pull in and out of the van so I can charge it if I have access to an outlet. So you can kind of see how much space I have. It's definitely like not the highest roof ever, but I'm really just using it as a place to sleep and get me from point A to point B. So I'm not too worried about headroom right now. I think eventually maybe I'll replace the roof and either get a top that pops up or just a permanent high top. But for now, that's all I need. And then you can see full-size bed and then storage here, storage up here. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Okay, with that, I think that pretty much wraps up the van tour. Stuff I missed. Like I said, the van is 2008. I bought it with about 40,000 miles on it for 25,000. Already had the 6-inch lift and the 4-wheel drive conversion kit on it. The inside was stock walls and ceiling, and then the bottom was just plywood flooring. And then I stripped everything, did everything myself. Had no idea how to do any of this stuff before I started. Pretty extensive learning process, but I figured it out. I'm really happy with the end product. It's perfect for me, exactly what I need. And I just want to thank you guys again for watching the video and supporting me on the journey. I know before the last video, I was very nervous about it and nervous about the whole process, but you guys have been awesome. You've given me a lot of love and support, dropping likes, subscribing. That video I posted 2 days ago, it's already almost at 1,000 views, which just completely blows my mind. I thought I would have been stoked if 5 people watched it and liked it, but like 1,000 people sitting in a single room and watching it, I can't even comprehend, which is a little overwhelming to me, but also super motivating and makes this journey even more exciting knowing that so many of y'all are subscribing and gonna be with me as I do it. So thanks again for that. And the next video, I'll be moving full-time into the van. It's October 1st whenever I move in, so a week from today. And that'll probably be the next video. I'll see you guys then. Later.